had a lot to do with the legislation, especially relating to jobs. We took that information off the register last year. Are you comfortable with registered sex offenders getting licenses from the state that allow them access to people's homes?
Well, it depends on, you have to be very specific, access to whose home, what the job description.
Well, we've got electricians, plumbers, real estate agents.
If they've been approved and licensed by a state agency and the homeowner invites them in, it's not a major concern, though.
Do you feel comfortable, and can you guarantee the public they'll be safe?
I can't ever guarantee anything to anybody, no more than you can guarantee something. But the bottom line is you depend on the nature of the sex offense. You know, we have 80,000 people who are on sexual registration lists. The police officers say that is way, way too many. So you have to define. Obviously, no predators, but if it's someone that made a mistake when they were in college and got labeled a sex offender, yeah, I would be for that person being rehabilitated and going to work.
Most people don't expect the state to send a licensed registered sex offender into their home.
I don't know who you're talking about, but
well,
these plumbers, electricians, a plumber who made a mistake as in college and was labeled a sex offender because he dated someone underage. It depends on the circumstances.
But the Romeo and Juliet, you tried to pass laws against that.
Romeo and Juliet would be a perfect example.
But
so it depends on the facial.
There have been attempts, though, haven't there, to pass that? To rectify it. You've made attempts to rectify.
We have a bill this session to do it. It depends on the circumstance of what the work, who the individual is, but to paint with a broad brush, there are some sex offenders that are not predators. There are some sex offenders that have outgrown their offense. So it depends on the circumstances.
Now, as far as state licenses,
you're just trying to scare everybody, and you're trying real hard, but you are doing a disservice to individuals that have been rehabilitated, licensed, and supervised to do electrical or plumbing work.
And last question. What do you say to the public who expects
when
someone...
I told you it depends on the individual. Public safety is the utmost concern.
So you're fine sending registered sex offenders into people's homes.
That's not what I said.
But that's what the state is doing.
I don't have time to repeat everything. You're obviously not wanting to hear. It depends on the offender. It depends on the nature of the offense. There are 80,000 people on sex registration offender lists. Officers say there should be about 10 to 20. So it depends on who you're talking about.
So all of these sex offenders are safe to be in people's homes?